cooking. The drip in my windows is sending us gold. My backseat ain't empty, we just left the Fendi. We getting it all over the place. This is why I need the family. This is why I need.
Welcome back to the channel. If you can hear someone over there, this is why. Bouncy, bouncy. Yeah. So yeah, I was supposed to pick up the camera. What? Right. Today's Saturday. Yeah, and this is the first time I picked up the camera. That's really bad. So yeah, this was meant to be like a full week, week of the life. Da da da. But no, it's not. So yeah, this could be going up next week, or it could be going up tomorrow, so we'll see. But yeah, so people would like the return of the vlogs, and people want to see like all different stuff.
Yeah,
obviously mum life, fitness, home life, daily vlogs, blah blah blah. People just like to be nosy, so yeah. We'll go with that, and I like to be nosy too, so it is what it is. But yeah, so on Instagram the other day, I asked if anyone had any questions or anything they want me to answer or want us to answer. This is probably going to be like more of an Abby and Remy channel, and Luke will just pop in as and when. So yeah, I'll be answering those questions at some stage, and let's just see what this vlog is. So I'm just going to answer some of the questions now with a little baby in the background. So she's like, what? So I put a question box up on, this is quite distracting. I put a question box up on Instagram, like I've just said, and I'm going to answer them now. See how long she gives me, because she'll be getting ready for a nap soon. So, yeah. So, the questions. The first question, managing work-life balance. So, I went back to work. I'm self-employed, work from home, whatever. I had 2 weeks off, 2 weeks fully off, totally off-grid, off work. So yeah, I had 2 weeks off maternity. Coming back to work, because for one, I had emergency section, so I couldn't drive. I came back to work because I wanted to come back to work. I wanted some normality in my life. I could not sit at home, couch potato, and not drive for 6 weeks. My recovery went very, very, very smooth, very well, very quick. So yeah, managing work-life balance now is very different to what it was, obviously. I probably can't push work as much as I would like to push work, for obvious reasons. You know, like there's me and Lou, only one of us can like push in a way. We can't both be like, okay, let's go, 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 because then who's going to have Remy, blah, 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 blah. Thank you. And all that stuff. So managing work-life balance can sometimes be hard, and I often find myself in the midst of, well, it's true, Remy's down for a nap, what do I need to get done? Or when Luke is free and is not working, or he's not got a call or a podcast or whatever, I'm like, I just need to do like this for an hour, can you just have Remy? And it's very much, it's a communication thing, and it's very much making it work with what we've got at the minute, obviously. So yeah, it can be hard, but it's not all bad. It's happening and it's working. So I'm going to do all the non-baby ones first. So fave content creator on YouTube, Instagram. I'm really bad for just sitting and scrolling, like it's really bad. You know, because work is on Instagram, work is online. It's so distracting. I couldn't tell you who my favourite Instagram people are. I'm very much like, okay, that's work, I'm posting for people to see. I'm not much of a scroller. So obviously, yeah. YouTube-wise, my favourite YouTubers to watch, and I need some more, so please comment below if you like anyone in particular. But Ellie Swift, Gemma Louise Miles, and I think that's it. I'm not into like watching bodybuilding stuff. I used to like Chrissy Chella. She's probably my favourite on Instagram, not so much YouTube. So I think that answers that question. And then I think everything else is to do with mum life shock. So let's go with tip you give to future mums to be about postpartum. No one can prepare you for it. No one. So you have. I'm not naive in any way. I knew it was going to be hard, a challenge. Well, no one can prepare you to have a baby. No one can prepare you for what your body's going to go through. No matter how much reading you do, no matter how much you prepare, it's just like, whoa, what? So yeah, you lose all dignity. And the early stages of postpartum literally hits you like a brick. Don't it? Yeah, it does. It does. Yeah, I know. It's not funny. Yeah, it literally hits you like a brick. You can't control your emotions. Now, if anyone knows me, I am not an emotional person at all. I will only cry at funerals. But I cried a lot during postpartum. And for me, that was like, oh my God. What's happening? I didn't cry. But you just can't control it. So yeah, it hits you like a ton of bricks. But everything is just a phase, and you will get through the other side. Like, you need support. You need a lot of support from your partner or your mum and dad or your partner's mum and dad or whatever, friends. You need support. You need people around you. And if you are not okay, don't say you are. Because yeah, and now going through it myself, I can fully understand postnatal depression. I fully get it. I didn't have it myself, but I understand it. Like, it is hard. Your whole life now revolves around your baby, and they're relying on you, and you're like, oh my God, what? Like, what if I do this wrong? You're questioning everything. So yeah, it's very, very hard. But don't get me wrong, it's friggin' unreal as well. Like, we've touched wood, had the most amazing baby ever. Who's really good, and you know, she's no trouble and all that stuff.
Yeah.
So obviously all the good times outweigh the bad, but postpartum, it is hard. And another thing, postpartum is for life. So even when I've got a 16-year-old, I will still be postpartum, because yeah, it's just a little bit mad. Tips you'll give to someone about birth or postpartum, no one ever told you. That's a tough one. What would you say? Bounce your way through it. I don't know, that's a tough one really, because it depends. You'll just never, I haven't really got any tips to be honest, you'll just never be prepared. No matter how much preparing you do, you'll never be prepared. And what you're expecting life to be like is going to be nothing like you expect it. Not in a bad way. But yeah, the main thing is, no matter how much you prepare, you cannot prepare. Can you?
No. No.
So yeah, that's the main thing I would say. Like, don't stress yourself out. That's easier said than done. But don't stress yourself out over it, because you'll just never be prepared fully.
Coming out.
So yeah, you'll never be prepared. Like, you can have loads of stuff, you can have everything in the world, and it just, not that it won't go to plan, but you'll just never be able to ever be able to get ready. Like, no one can ever prepare you for, you're gonna become a mum, ever. So yeah. What struggles have you faced that you didn't expect? I would say, like, not that I didn't expect. I'm a very routine person, so we've got her into a routine really, really quickly. But you have to go with them. No matter what you want them to do, if they don't want to do it, they're not going to do it. And you have to work together. I think what struggles at first, what I didn't expect, was to be so emotional. I was so emotional. And the fact that you have to just rest and do nothing. Obviously, every birth is different. But for me to sit and just let people do stuff around me, because obviously I couldn't friggin' move. I was like, oh my God, I can't do it. But yeah, I would say those two things. How are you adapting to parenthood? I friggin' love it. I love it. Don't get me wrong, it's hard. And some days you're like, you don't know what they want and all this kind of stuff. But yeah, I love it. She fits into life perfect. And you just forget what life was like without them, really. It's pretty mad. Yeah. So yeah, I'm adapting really well. Thanks for asking.
We're in a little rave, aren't we? Go, go, go! Woo-hoo-hoo. Not been knowing that Abby's done exactly the same thing, just got Remy in a dancing seat. Welcome back. And probably said as well that last time we actually was doing video, it was when we moved in here, but now we've got... Yeah, yeah, we've got Remy. She's saying hello, aren't you? She's probably getting a little bit... Oh, no. Well, it might be time for me to go. What? What's up? Hey, hello. Woo! Bouncy, bouncy. So, yeah, Remy's in our world. Almost getting on for 6 months. She's been...
You've been all right, haven't you?
No, she's been the dream. So, yeah. Abby's just currently cleaning. I've cleaned the cars this morning. Not saying it's a weekend job all the time, but, well, it actually is, to be honest. But yeah, Remy's going to bounce. We are going to the spa later. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I know you're going to have a sleepover. Grandma's, Mama's. That's what you're going to be doing. So, yeah, so it's a whirlwind. It's good chaos. We love it, don't we? I'll let Remy do all the talking. But it's good to be back and excited to obviously document and see everything in, I would probably say Remy's world, but a little bit of our world as well. So we're ready to, I guess, share again. It's been quite overwhelming. A lot's been going on, but good things and obviously some down parts as well. Before I go, I just want to say thank you, Kim, for our gift. We're excited and we've got a massage later as well. Oh, can't remember the last time we had a massage. So that's it. We're going to go, aren't we?
We're about to go.
To the spa.
Look who's chilling. No one can see my face. She's like, I'm smiling.
Heidi Boom.
On a scale of 1 to 10, I should say. Yeah. How much are you looking forward to a massage?
Oh, so much. Remy's having a sleepover at my mum and granddad's.
Said it earlier, actually, yeah, but she's. She looks like she's chilling.
Comfortable? Are you comfortable?
What are we baking?
Get more
than
hair on
the wall. Come on, real coach.
Oh, go away. What?
This video, what are we doing? Should I explain? Because this recipe seems to be online everywhere.
Making protein pancakes, alright? Oh, I've got a question for you, actually. Someone asked, what was labour like for you?
Obviously, I can't answer that. So, to answer the question, what was labour like for me? First of all, seeing Abby in a lot of pain and discomfort was actually quite heart-wrenching in a way, because obviously you literally can't do anything. So you just sat there, I was massaging Abby's back, just helping her breathe. She had the... It was a stopwatch, weren't it?
Timer,
what was it? What were your contractions?
I can't remember. I had 30 seconds.
Yeah, but...
30 seconds of rest.
So literally, I was just looking at her phone and saying, right, take an inhalation of the gas and air and then breathe out. And then I was obviously rubbing her back because that was her most comfortable position. I think as well, it was just the duration of the whole day. It did actually seem to go by pretty quick, but it was just a lot of pain. That's, I think, we're obviously a lot more pain for Abby, but I think for me, I was just, is there anything I can do? I was trying to keep her calm, because Abby's not one of those people for like full-blown conversations when she's in a lot of pain or any sort of pain, what, any sort of like, what?
Any
motivational talk or just, come on, you've got this. It's like,
don't talk to me.
Talk slow, calm, yeah. That's pretty much it.
So,
so yeah, just a lot. It was a blur. It just seemed to be, I just had to be there and completely focus on you in the moment, really. All right, okay. It's on one bar, you know, battery.
I know, I'm charging the other.
Right, I better finish it then. I ain't got much time, which is not good, because I like to talk.
You can't tell.
I don't even know what I was saying before, but yeah, just, oh, the labour.
Yeah.
I was labour, yeah.
For you?
Yeah, just, it was intense, it was a lot. I felt a lot of pressure because obviously I couldn't really do anything. It's one of those things that you never can really, it's hard to explain it when, you know, you're trying to relive it, but you've got to be in it at that moment in time. I think that's really where it was at. But I just obviously had a lot of sympathy and emotion towards Abby because she was in so much pain. So for me, it's about keeping calm and being engaged. So, you know, it's not about just, I don't know, you got to be there. You got to be in it 100%. So it was draining for me and it was a lot of my energy. But yeah, that's all I can really say about it. Does that answer the question or?
Well, I don't know. I
don't know because I felt like I weren't answering it right when I was talking earlier.
Well, you weren't talking about you earlier.
I was talking about you though. How I felt. Yeah, overwhelmed. Obviously, it's a lot. So yeah, the battery died on us, didn't it?
It did.
So United. Don't play with it. Don't be the size. Still not a.